So it's Lent 4 in the gospel reading of John chapter 6, and Jesus is out in the middle of nowhere, and the apostles are out there with him, and all of a sudden, like 5,000 people crash the place looking for some food. Everybody wants to hear Jesus teach. Everybody wants to see some more miracles. And Philip looks at Jesus, and Jesus looks at Philip, and Jesus says to Philip, "Where are we going to buy bread so that all these 5,000 people may eat?" And he said this in order to test Philip, for he himself knew what he would do. And we freak out at the idea that God would test us. We do our very best to prove to him that we are worthy. We figure Philip failed the test because he said, you know, there's a boy here with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, but what are they among so many? This isn't going to work at all. Philip failed the test. And it gives us great joy. See, here's the thing. Philip failed the test, but everybody still ate. It's not about that. And also, if God was really God and actually knew everything, why does he need to test us? Why does he need to figure something out as if he wouldn't already know it? You see, there's something different that happens when God tests us than when we test each other. See, we test each other to see something about each other. So you will give me a test to see whether or not I know math. And you will learn that I do not know math. But when God tests us, he already knows that I am a sinner and I don't know math. And so when God would test us, it's not so that he can learn more about us. God tests us so that we can learn more about him. God tests Philip not so that he can figure out whether or not Philip is a sinner. He knows. He tests Philip so that Philip will see what God is going to do. He himself already knows what he is going to do. Philip's right or wrong answer cannot change that thing. Jesus is going to take bread and after giving thanks, break it and give it to the disciples and everyone will be fed. God tests us in this life, not simply to find out whether or not we're worthy. He knows we're not. That's why he comes into this world to die upon the cross for us. That's why he won't stay out in the wilderness and just give bread to people. He has to carry their sins into Jerusalem and then out into the field, out into the hill of Golgotha, and there he has to bear them unto nothing. But in the meanwhile, when God tests you in your life, when he gives you the things that you can't handle, the things that you will fail, it's not so that you can be proven unworthy. It's so that you can actually look up and recognize that none of these things are enough to pry you from the hand of your Savior. None of these things are enough to undo the salvation that he has already won for you on that cross where he already died for you. None of these things that you are so afraid of can rip from you the kingdom. And if we're going to be honest, most of the things that we're convinced are going to ruin our life don't do near as bad as they ought should have, because God has protected us. He has really, really, really curbed the damage that sin should do in this world. It's a small miracle that I am still walking and talking this day, because I should have just done killed myself a long time ago. But God in his mercy keeps us, keeps you. And even where the temptation becomes so strong, the test becomes so potent that we even stop drawing breath because it just kills us, God will raise us again. He just says, no, watch what I will do. I will rise from the grave and you will rise too. Be not afraid. When God tests us, these are trying times, painful times, not the fun times. Philip had no idea what to do, but he learned something about God's character. He learned how great and merciful and loving and powerful that he is. And all of these things, he learned that he would work them, not for the deserving, but the undeserving, even for him. Did we do good? Is that okay? If you liked that, hit the button that says that you like that. Maybe even subscribe to see more of these. Even give. Help us fund this mission of making known the gifts of Christ Jesus to youth and young adults. If you like this video, check out our website, higherthings.org, and check out more content from Higher Things.